Good morning. Thank you so much, Noah, for waking us up with such wonderful music. A round of applause for our pianist this morning. Good morning, and I'd like to welcome you to the Student of the Month breakfast ceremony. My name is Kelly Dassel. I'm the assistant principal for the class of 2016. It's my pleasure to be hosting this event, and it is indeed an honor for these students to be recognized. As we all know, what a large group of students we have here at LT. They've managed to single themselves out with the teachers that are present. The students being honored here today will be presented by their nominating teacher, and the teacher will share why they chose to nominate this student. However, because of teaching schedules, please understand that some of our teachers will need to leave when they're done presenting for your student, as they have a first hour class that they need to attend to. So we're going to begin now. We're going to start with our physical welfare department. I'd like to welcome up Ms. Melissa Mitadero. Ms. Mitadero.
Hi, my name is Missy Mitadero. It is my pleasure to award Luke Lopez the Physical Welfare Student of the Month. Luke is such a pleasure to have in class. He's a great representation of the Physical Education Department. He not only is a great classmate, but also a helpful and welcome friend to students in need. Luke is diligent, hardworking, and demonstrates consistency in his effort with everything that we do in class. He is has such a selfless attitude in that he befriends students who are in need of being included and supported. He is the first student to lend a hand to others and myself in need. His friendship to students and effort in class is what gives me the pleasure to award Luke Lopez the Physical Welfare Student of the Month. I actually want to add something, too, that I didn't write before this. But yesterday we were playing in badminton, and one of the kids that he usually helps and usually assists, he told me that that Luke was his best buddy the other day. So very, very cute. Good job. Congrats.
Our next presenter this morning is from our Business Education Department. I'd like to welcome up Mr. George Lowen and his student. Mr. Lowen.
Morning, this is Maya Wilkins. I kind of cheated this month when we were asked to nominate a student. Maya is in my consumer economics class right now, but she's kind of a crossover student because she was in accounting one last year and will be in accounting two in the spring. So it's kind of a combination of all three of them. And if you know Maya, you know she's always smiling, like she is right now. She's great attitude, great to contribute to class. She's comfortable in questioning me, like, Mr. Lowen, you get that test graded, kind of, in a nice, respectful way. But also, what kind of makes her stand out is probably best examples in accounting. She has an interest in going into that area, and when she came back in the fall, she came up to me after class and said, you know, hey, do we have any internship opportunities for high school students? And I'm thinking, wow, normally that's for college, but sure, I'll send a couple emails, and we found one for her. So she's going to be helping a CPA in the spring. Still working out? Yeah, we're okay. Make sure we're still on track. Helping out a CPA in the spring during tax season. I thought it's a great opportunity for her, and I think that kind of summarizes what she's all about. She wants to get the most out of her education. She clearly knows there are a lot of really good things here at LT, and she wants to take advantage of them. And that's kind of why she stands out to me as a student of the month. Congratulations.
Our next presenter this morning is from our social studies department. I'd like to welcome up Mr. John Seipel. Mr. Seipel.
Good morning, everyone. My name is John Seipel. I teach psychology here at North Campus. And before I even get started with AJ, I want to also congratulate. I've got four students here today, you know, out of my classes, which is awesome. Congratulations to Luke, Ruben, Valencio, and let me think who the other one was. Sorry, the person's not here yet. But it'll come to mind in just a second. Let me talk about AJ, and then we'll get to the last person. But AJ is my October Student of the Month. And AJ was in my Psychology for Life class last fall, first period. And one of the things that I remembered about AJ when I saw his name in August on my class list, AJ was always in my class at 7:30 in the morning. He was always the first person in class. And when you talk about high school students trying to get here at 7:45 and being awake, this young man was always awake and ready to go asking questions. And that was one thing I loved about him last fall, or last spring. And then I get him this fall, and I get him in my seventh period class, my Psychology of the Mind class. And once again, first person in class, asking questions. One of the things I like to do in my classes is always refer back to other psychology issues. And the nice part with AJ is always the one who's raising his hand saying, oh yeah, I remember that from last spring. It's about this or it's about that. And AJ is always there, always ready to go, always eager. And this is why he's my October Student of the Month. Thanks. Congratulations, AJ. My other student was Eric Pittman. Sorry.
That's okay.
There you go. That makes it a little easier sometimes. Our next presenter is going to be from our science department. Unfortunately, her student is not able to be here, and that is Eric Pittman. So Mrs. Brunuskis is going to come up. We don't want to overlook him because I know she has some nice words to say about him. So Ms. Brunuskis.
Good morning. I chose Eric as my student of the month for how he just interacts within the classroom. He comes in ready to experiment with food every morning, first period. Students are always seeking him out for help. If there's ever a math question, it's come to the point where students will look for Eric to help them before they come to me. And just a calming presence in the classroom when he's there. So that's why I chose Eric as my Science Student of the Month.
Our next presenter this morning is from our mathematics department. I'd like to welcome up Ms. Chris Blachinski. Ms. Blachinski.
Good morning. My name is Chris Blachinski, and I've taught math here at LT for a long, long time. And I'm here today to honor Trace Mortimer as my Math Student of the Month. Last summer, while most students were enjoying a break from the rigor and routine of academic life during the summer, perhaps even sleeping in a little bit, Trace was right here taking accelerated pre-calculus for 6 weeks, 4 to 5 hours a day, a course that I actually teach during the regular academic year over the course of 38 weeks. It's a loaded, challenging course, and Trace decided to enroll in that course, not because he had failed it the year before and was retaking it, and not because he wanted to fulfill a graduation requirement to ease his senior year course load, but because in eighth grade, Trace found himself on a track that would have prevented him from taking calculus his senior year, and he decided to do something about that. So he decided to enter into an additional math course, taking five then over the course of his high school career. And I am proud of you for that, really proud of you for that. And I'm here today, of course, not just to honor Trace because of his initiative and his ambition, but because he's hit the ground running in calculus, where I met him this fall. Each and every day, Trace, you are 100% engaged. You are active, and this is at 7:45 in the morning, another early morning class to be taking an advanced placement course. And perhaps most notably, Trace has earned a 100% not just on the first unit test, but on the first two unit tests. And in 20 years of teaching calculus, I don't think that's ever happened before. And so this is a student to be honored, and I am so incredibly proud of you. Again, for your initiative, but also for taking full advantage of every learning opportunity that's been presented to you. And so I congratulate Trace. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Our next presenter is going to be from our Applied Arts Department, Mr. Blake Saunders. Unfortunately, his student also was not able to be here today, so he is going to be just saying a few words about them. Mr. Saunders.
Good Good morning. My name is Blake Sodders. I teach in the Applied Arts Department that typically is our engineering and architecture is what I have. Andrew is a young man I had last year in engineering class. This year I have an engineering design, which is our CAD class. What you may or may not know about Andrew, he's very quiet, doesn't say too much. Last year he just kind of sat there and did his work, and which is okay. This year I've seen a complete turnaround from Andrew. There's a young man that sits next to him. He struggles a little bit in class, and he always asks Andrew for help. And at first I was like, oh, this is not going to go well. No, it doesn't happen. Andrew is quickly to help him as much as he can. If he doesn't know the answer, he just kind of tells the kid, give me 1 minute and he'll check. And typically he'll ask myself or ask somebody else next to him. And in a class of 25 kids that are learning basically a foreign language, it works out really nicely. So I've chosen Andrew because of his ability to articulate himself and to help other students and really come out of that shell. So if Andrew was here, I would tell him congratulations. I will do that in class during second hour. Hopefully he's awake then. Have a good day.
Is that he's somebody who is constantly prepared to work, helps those around him, and that he really is caring and compassionate to have in the classroom. So for that, I would like to thank Andrew for his contributions.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, sure. We get it.
Our next presenter this morning is from our art department. I'd like to welcome up Mr. Matt Brode. With him today is Delia Valentin. He also nominated a second student, Ruben Fulgencio, of which he'll also mention a few words. Mr. Brode.
Good morning. I'm Matt Brode from the art department. And we do have two nominees for art department student of the month, and Delia was able to join us this morning and Ruben was not. I know that nobody in this room is a stranger to hard work. Students have worked hard to find a seat at the breakfast table this morning. Adults in the room, parents, administrators, teachers, we all know that we give of ourselves to our youngsters, and that comes with the territory. But sometimes students aren't always so willing to go above and beyond for their colleagues, for the other students in the program. And Delia stands out as unique and exceptional in the way that she contributes her time to keep the art department running smoothly. Delia volunteers as an art aide, and she comes into the ceramic studio every day and volunteers her own time to load kilns and mix glazes and mix clay. There's a lot of kind of behind the scenes work that goes on in running a clay studio and kind of optimizing that learning environment for the students that come in and out of that classroom every day. And Delia serves a vital role, an important part in making sure that the program runs smoothly and we do our best for everybody in the program, not just ourselves. That being said, hey, good morning, Ruben, come on up here. That being said, clay is also Delia's muse. I watch her engage with her material. I watch her love for the material and how she interacts and creates beautiful things. And I think that in addition to her service, in addition to that component of her character, I wanted to acknowledge this morning. I also wanted to say it's been a real pleasure to kind of work with you and see you work with clay and do your best with that. All right, so thank you very much. And to my left is Ruben Fulgencio, and Ruben is a young man of few words. About to remain a man of mystery in our minds forever, but he showed up and spoiled the surprise. I've known Ruben for 2 years, and I've worked with him over the space of 2 years, and I think that when I think about Ruben and what defines his role in the classroom, to me, he is a youngster of great character. As I mentioned, he doesn't say much, but in his silence, I find great strength. And I find his presence in the classroom to be kind of intuitive and engaged and ambitious and reflective. And we see all of those things that we love to see in learners at LT in a student like Ruben. I think with both Delia and Ruben, you know, this is an exciting time. I can't believe it's the end of the first quarter, but especially with seniors, getting to kind of share with them this this last year and the milestone experience of high school and how they're kind of leaving LT to shape the world. And I know that with youngsters like Delia and Ruben shaping our future, we're in compassionate hands, we're in talented hands, we're in loving hands, we're in really good hands. So congratulations to both of you.
Presenting this morning from our English department, I'd like to welcome up Ms. Nick Galicchio. Her student was not able to join us, so she's going to say a few words on the student's behalf. Ms. Galicchio.
Hi, I brought a bit of a prop so you could see Lauren's self-portrait of sorts. At the beginning of class for creative writing, I asked the students to just write me an introduction letter telling me a little bit about themselves. And this is what Lauren gave me. And this kind of, you know, shows you what she's all about. She's very creative, obviously. And there was a little fact about her on each one of these folded cranes, which would make you think that it's hard to get to know her. But it's really not. She wears her heart on her sleeve. She allows herself to be vulnerable in her writing. And that is the number one thing that any creative teacher could ask for. Because good writing, you know, makes you be honest with yourself. And she's not afraid to do that, like so many of us are. So it was tough to fold these all back up again after, but it was worth it. And it's been so amazing to get to know her juggernaut of a personality. So thank you, Lauren.
Presenting from our World Language Department, I'd like to welcome up Ms. Dulcinea Garcia, who's going to be talking to us about Grady Davis. Ms. Garcia.
Hi, everyone. So this is Grady Davis, better known as Nacho in my class. He was selected as the Spanish Student of the Month. I've had the pleasure of having him for 2 years now. And have witnessed his ability to successfully succeed in the language. But apart from his success in the Spanish language, I chose him because his enthusiasm in the class really shows, and his love for Spanish gets everybody else in the class really excited and pumped up. And because he's participating and he's so excited, everyone else always wants to participate. And I'm happy that I have a student like him in my class. I think every teacher wants students like that in their class. He is always more than willing to cooperate, and I can always count on him to volunteer, read, or answer questions. Even if there's an awkward silence for a while, he'll be the first one to like help me out so it's not too awkward. One specific moment that I'll never forget is we had a decades fashion show this year, and it's just something I created to practice like the words in Spanish with fashion words that we were learning, and he walked on the runway like it was his calling in life. He even like brought a boombox because he was 80s, and he walked down to the song Physical, and he got the crowd so pumped up. He was pointing at everyone. Like, it was amazing. Everyone was really excited, and I'm just really happy to have him in my class.
Our final presenter this morning is from our Family and Consumer Science Department. Division Chair Jason Lavix will be presenting on behalf of Martha Elliott, our teacher, and he's going to be telling us a little bit about Mattis McLean. Mr. Lavix.
Good morning. Mrs. Elliott approached me a couple weeks ago to present Mattis because she wasn't going to be able to be here, and I asked her to tell me about her so that I could say a lot, and she said a lot of the same stuff all these other teachers have. She's great in class. She has an interest and a passion about early childhood internship and takes the responsibility of working with those children in the community at a really high level. And the 10-minute conversation that I thought was going to be a minute was really interesting as to finding out about her. But most interesting to me was that Martha said that she is a fun student to have in class. A lot of the things that they cover can be challenging because you are going in and you're learning to teach and work with those kids in the community. And she models everything that you need to have in a good student. You know, she works well with others. She has the interest in what she's learning about. and the dedication. So congratulations.
That's going to conclude our ceremony this morning, but before you leave, I'd like to thank some people who are here. I'd like to thank Candy Faye from LTTV, who's recording this, and it will be available if you access the LTTV channel and give it a little bit of time. It takes some editing. Also, I'd like to thank my assistant in the back, Sandy Marciniak. She really puts this together, and I can't thank you enough for all your hard work, Sandy. Thanks to Noah, who got us started this morning with some fantastic music. Thanks to the students that are here today. You've set yourself apart from others in this building by your hard work, commitment, integrity, thoughtfulness, fun nature, as well as your leadership and positive attitudes. And to the parents that are here, I'd like to thank and congratulate you. Without your continual support, commitment, and guidance, we wouldn't have such fine citizens to recognize this morning. Thank you for coming, and if I could ask all of the students to step outside in front of the Wall of Fame as we conclude here, we'd like to get a picture of you for the website, so if you'll join us for that. Everyone else, feel free to stay, have another cup of coffee, something else to eat. Your students will be joining you back in just a second.